I guess I'll just do this. Oh, it's a Solotron.
Yeah. Hey. I had some good matches today.
Nice. Playing Smash. I'm recording video right now.
Oh, am I interrupting?
No, you're fine. Smile, you're on camera. I am so bad at the game of Spiral Knights now, though. Holy crap. It's been so long. I'm getting destroyed by drones or shankles.
Oh no.
This is my life. Yeah, anyways.
When was the last time you played?
I don't know. I've played 4 hours in the last month, apparently. It's pretty sad. But, just kind of going over some of our first impressions of the Gunner update. Did you buy any of the new guns?
Mm-hmm.
Or craft?
I crafted the armor. I have the recipes for the gun, but I never bothered to get the 5-star yet.
Which one did you prioritize first? What were you most interested in getting?
For costume reasons, it was... This is gonna be a long name, but it was the Grizzly Sentinel Guardian Armor.
Cool.
Alright, so I remember that.
Alright.
And then the weapon I was gonna craft, but I never got to it, was the Black Retribution.
Right.
The one with the Shadow Machine Gun, call it.
The Shadow Blitz Needle.
And then it was gonna be the Freezing Polaris. Then I never bothered with the helmets. They weren't in my taste.
And I like how you said I was going to buy, because... I don't know, did you ever make any of them? Like, the weapons?
The weapons... I'm up to... Let's see, I still have the recipe for it. I have the 4-star version of the Retribution. Let me see. Recipe, here we go. The Black Chain Gun recipe I still have.
It's basically a Blitz Needle that deals shadow damage instead of piercing.
So, honestly, I only got it for the way it looks.
That's valid.
Yeah, red dot eyesight.
Yep. Oh, it's a really cool looking model. They did a really good job with it.
And people speculated it was gonna be an NPC weapon only, because we looked at the designs like, this can't be for us. It looks too cool to be for us.
Yep.
So when it came, that was basically one of the first guns people wanted to get, aside from, what did people prioritize first? I think it was the Polaris, I think. Yeah.
I don't know. A lot of people, to me, expressed interest in those guns.
I had interest just because how do you shoot something and then it freezes in the explosion?
Yep.
And then I wondered about, what was it, the Valiance, the Elemental, and Piercing.
Right.
Not a lot of people got interested in it.
Yeah, it was like, come on guys, what's up? Like, you think people would pick it up for Lockdown and stuff. I don't know what the current Lockdown meta is, or if anyone's even playing Lockdown.
I think it's, let me see, how many people are playing Lockdown now?
But I mean, it seems like you could capitalize with the Shadow one, because very few people bring Shadow Defense, because the other armors are just stronger.
Yeah, either the Skull Vogue and
Chaos,
or the Cat.
Right.
Thing. Only, there's 24 playing and 5 waiting. That's decent.
It's kind of sad for a Sunday evening. I mean, it's kind of late, yes, but... And so, the glory days are over for now. For now.
What other guns were there? Alliance. I almost forgot the piercing version of
the Antigua. Or the...
Silver Six. What's after Silver Six?
The Argent Peacemaker.
Oh, yeah. A piercing version of that. I don't know if people were interested in... I think... Because didn't it had an effect with it?
I don't think so. It might have had a family bonus. Because that's what the Argent Peacemaker and Satenza have. The Griffin. The Gilded Griffin.
I would guess it has like Fiend or Wolver.
Let's see if it says. I still have the mail in my thing here. No, it doesn't say.
Book auction house, but yeah, those were people. I know how many people came when I first saw the gunner update. I guess like because normally when a new update comes, everyone joins in, and then they either all leave right away or they stick around. Right. And it was half and half. Half of the people left, but most of them stayed for like at least 2 weeks.
Yep. Well, it was good to see. The game came alive again for a little bit.
Mm-hmm. And people were testing out the guns, and once they tested it out, I guess after a few rounds of lockdown with their new guns, I guess they just wanted to see what else is going to come by.
Right. And I think that says something about the game, too. And I'll act all podcasty and professional about this, but I was talking about this a little bit. It says something about the game because people went and they took their guns to lockdown, and then they had their experience with their guns, and like, alright, that was fun shooting people, and then they put it down and walked away from the game.
Which, yeah.
I mean, to me, says we need more level content, because it's a hack and slash where everyone has seen all of the dungeons.
Yeah, and there's really, I mean, new weapons are fine, but even if you tried on the clockworks where you already played most of the missions that you already seen before, there's not really a lot of variety. Mm-hmm. So with how you use it, because these weapons are new, sort of. I mean, it's different versions of the same weapons, because we already seen an RG Peacemaker. This is just a piercing version of that.
Right.
We've seen the Black Retribution, which is the shadow version of a Blitz Needle. And I don't know, when people got like saw these, they didn't think of using it in Clockworks because they already used those kinds of weapons before.
Right.
It's just a different element to it. And so after lockdown, you would just say, oh, that's everything I could do with this weapon because I already know how it works and I have fun with it. So now I gotta wait for something new to come by. And so
right,
right now only promos are people's priorities.
And we can tell people are starting to get tired of those, maybe a little bit.
People still buy them, but I don't know how many. I just know it's either two ways. Either a person buys one every once in a while, or there's always this one person that buys a successive amount, maybe like 10 or 15, to get something good and then just wear it all the whole time. And then they wait for the next one and then buy the whole thing of that because they have jobs and they can earn money, and they were like, I'm gonna spend this much on Spiral Knights because I want to.
That's what it is. Spiral Knight still gets like $1,000 every time they run a promo, so like, oh, okay, let's keep running them. And it's really just like three people buying all the boxes
because they can, because some of them work and they earn money and they have like probably extras and they just wanted to spend it on this game because they still have an interest in it.
Right.
It's just that everywhere is a different circumstance where it's either getting these boxes or the other side is to get new levels or new bosses. Then I think, I don't know if they would decide on the levels, but I'm pretty sure most of them want to see a change in how the updates work in Spiral Knights. Mm-hmm. Right now, it's just been a fashion party here.
It's true.
Who can be the most fashionable person of the year, or the month, or the season?
Or the promo.
That's true.
Now, so Nick did, before he left, he previewed two things, right? The Arcade Redux, which seems to be where Three Rings' priority is, which is at, like, quote-unquote Tier 4, whatever this new antagonist for the game is. And then the other thing was like this arcade like challenge mode kind of thing. Can't mm-hmm. remember exactly what he called it. Do you remember what he called it?
Arcade challenge. Oh, it was I know it was part of the Arcade Redux thing.
Yeah, it was going to be some extra feature that they added so you could have an extra challenge when you played the game or, like, cooperatively do stuff with friends. It was just going to be some harder mode of some kind. Honestly, don't remember what he said. It's the what's next for Spiral Knight's post that Nick made. I think it might even still be pinned on the forums. I'm not sure. Maybe not.
I could check right now. I'm in the forums right now looking at people's... I'm still reading RPs, people making the treasure roll because reasons. Let me see, general discussion. Is it in the general discussion or?
Yeah, it would have been.
This was way back, like, did Nick leave again? Storm fall?
I suppose so.
Between fall and summer. I just remember because the statue appeared in the garden.
Right. Our great lord and creator.
Yeah. Dave. This might take a while.
It's fine if you don't want to. Basically, it was that... There, he didn't say much about it, was the thing.
Here we go, found it.
Oh yeah? What did he call it?
What's in development, Tempender?
Right.
Okay, arcade redux, if they're a great deal, yes. Modify rank mission campaign. New 3D bus, challenge mode.
Challenge mode. See, I'm not making this stuff up.
Yeah, challenge mode. In addition to the new exciting features we are planning for the arcade and ranked mission, we're busy working on all new challenge mode that will allow players to work as a team in cooperative scenarios and compete with other teams for high score. Challenge mode will also feature rewards for those who really excel. So yeah, it was... I remember we talked about this, like actually competing against other teams
mm-hmm.
for high scores, and it thought it would be a really neat addition
mm-hmm.
to this. Now we just gotta wait for it to appear.
Right. We talked about on the podcast the different ways we thought it might be competitive. So it's like, wait, are you speed running it? Like, are we going for time, or are we going for like some point system, or?
Or like killing the most monsters in a certain speed, or
right.
Or and how to track people's scores based on that.
But I guess, speculation. We did a lot of that on the podcast also. But I'm curious, like, would you rather have the tier 4 boss or the challenge mode? Because I think the tier 4 boss is, like, the endgame content that everyone... I say tier 4 in quotes, obviously. There's no tier 4 that's been confirmed. But would you rather have that? Because that's the endgame content that everyone seems to be the dream of everyone. Or challenge mode, which sounds like it has a lot more replayability. I don't know, the bosses tend to have lots of replayability to farm all the tokens.
Farming.
But it seems like challenge mode may bring life into the game for people that want kind of a more competitive side to just this hack and slash kind of thing.
What would I go for? Well, I don't really want to see... I do want to see end content. Then again, I also want to see what's inside of the core, but... I think challenge mode would be something interesting if it was like done so drastically different than the other updates that they come up with, then yeah, I would totally go for it.
Yeah,
like if it was as different as the Dark Harvest thing that they did with
yeah.
the that was interesting. I played so much of that.
Apocrypha.
Yeah.
Wait, I'm still playing Spiral Knights, right?
Like suddenly you get grabbed by tentacles like, I don't like this, I need an adult. And then all of a sudden you end up in this like different atmosphere and you're just like in terror of what were Three Rings thinking, what is this? This is not Spiral Knights I know.
Yeah. And yet the atmosphere was so, it was Spiral Knights though was the thing, it so much was it. And yet you could still tell by looking at it, this is still, like, the game that I like to play.
Mm-hmm.
Even if I don't like to play it, because there's tentacles. But yeah, I totally agree. I think for either update, if they just make something that's refreshing, right? Yeah. And I feel like a content update would be refreshing. Like, actual... Yes, there's one aspect of let me take my guns and shoot around, but there's another thing of let me play a new level, or new level sets, or try a new challenge that's gonna take me many tries to get.
Those puzzles in your Procreo update, that was honestly one of the best puzzles I did in Spawn Knights, rather than just shoot this switch. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, there's another switch. Okay. I did it. I completed the puzzle.
Yeah. And there was a certain excitement even initially because no one knew how to solve a lot of them. And it was just kind of rumors and like forum speak. So it was a question of, do I like farm my sigils or do I stay and try to figure out these puzzles at the risk of getting grasped and lasered, eye lasered.
Yeah. That, not, well, let me see, when did they announce this? In 9 is October, December, November, October, yeah, October, this was October 9th, and now, since Nick left in this update, can we consider when this will come? Or when it would be too late for it to come, because we waited almost more than a year for the Gunner update. Now, how long would this arcade redux take to be along with the new tier 4 and challenge mode?
Mm-hmm. Well, he says they're hard at work on it, so I assume they already had some content for it down.
Remember when when was that gun that Glacies got that was...
The overcharged Mixmaster?
Yeah. I would think that was one of their earliest gunner, quote-unquote gunner update guns.
Yeah.
And I always thought they just want to see how this would test out.
Mm-hmm.
And it turns out to be broken and stuff.
Yeah, it turned out to be broken and that scared us a bunch because we're like, oh my goodness, what are they doing?
The new gunner update.
What's going to happen when they release? But it released and it was nice and polished, which mm-hmm. I do like. There wasn't anything broken with the initial release of the actual gunner update.
Mm-hmm.
Which was good.
I actually looked upon the number of people that initially came for between when the Gunner update came, the Winterfest, and now. And it turns out more than 500 people came at day one of the Gunner update, and then it grew up to approximately 850. Now, since that was close to the Winterfest update, it grew even more later on.
Mm-hmm.
And then once it hit halfway up the Winterfest, that's when everyone started leaving.
Yeah.
And then I was like, wait, so the peak of when everyone came is approximately like 850 to 900. So, from a game perspective, I mean, that... It sounds huge, but it's not
mm-hmm.
for a game, because my friend showed me a game that was basically all about socializing, and there was no hack and slash, there was no gameplay, it was just chatting, socializing, and creating your own thing. I forgot what it's called. Pongo, some... It was like a Club Penguin kind of game.
Hmm.
And that got over 5,000 people.
Right.
And teenagers, and I was like, how is this getting more than something as Spiral Knights? And I would think it's because Spiral Knights is not being heard of
right
as much.
Mm-hmm.
Because not many people would, when I first started college, that was when I first started playing this game, and so I did most of my projects based on this game, and people were asking me about it. Right. I told them this was a game, but they never heard of it, and I told them that this was a free thing and I like to play on this. And out of my years of being in college playing this, only two people I know, when I first met them, they heard of this game and actually played it.
Mm-hmm. That's a pretty niche, small game, and there's honestly a lot of MMORPGs out there. Especially the farther east you go, there's a lot of them.
Mm-hmm.
But you're right, it doesn't have the most exposure in the world.
There hasn't... I know I've seen ads of this game, but whenever you go on... Whenever you click on an MMO site, and all of a sudden, after that, people start seeing Sparrow Knight ads.
Yep.
But that was the only time you ever heard of it. And people will only get on this game just because they have Steam, and they play TF2, and then they open the other free-to-play games, and it was like, oh, what's this game?
I'll be honest, that's how I started. Well, that's how I found out about it, was I got notified through TF2 that this thing was a thing, and I ended up trying it.
And then the hat that comes with it.
Yep.
Yeah, that's how I got in it too. Once I found Steam, and once I started playing TF2, I got here. And I enjoyed it.
Yep. And now look where we are.
Well, then again, we're not, like, playing this as much as we used to. We're just, like, coming and going.
Right. But it's better than nothing at all. Man, what could... I kind of want to talk about it again now. I mean, just kind of not in the official, hey, let's... Officially, but just kind of from the heart. That sounds so cheesy. Just like, oh man, what would happen if they introduced either the challenge mode or the tier 4 boss? And I know there's been a lot of speculation of this on the forums, but it just kind of excites me. It's like, because I was just saying in the video before you got here, there's so much potential for this game. It's got so much going for it and so much it could do.
Mm-hmm.
Just with the way that the game is built. Also, I got an Ecto drop on the prize wheel. GG.
GG, well done, sir. You can sell that off for all those crowns you can get off the traders.
Yeah, buddy.
Now, the arcade redux. You know what I always wanted to see? I wanted to see, like, the Steam built-in thing where people can create their own stuff and people could just download it into the game and see... I wanted to see... That's what I thought when I heard of arcade redux, where you build... When you see uncreated levels.
Right.
Like, I know we talked about how is there like a number of spawns you can make? Will this give you less crowns than the regular arcade mode? And how much are you able to put in? Can you put in the specific amount of family? Or you can put all types of family in one map?
Right.
Can you put a boss in the map? I always wanted to put my own music in the map. Just have it like that. I wanted to see some sort of Gmod-ish thing going on with it.
Mm-hmm.
Having my not just the level design, and having your own like stairways and broken clockworks, or maybe have a story to go with the map you make.
Mm-hmm.
But to also be able to have like a sort of rules to go with it, instead of just doing the same thing in the arcade where you could just either pass on without finding any mobs or fight all the mobs and just get through the level, maybe have a certain objective. Yep. And maybe it could be all puzzle related.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like this challenge where you had to bring a certain gun or a certain bomb. Or maybe have only two people to solve this puzzle.
Right. Did you ever play Bastion?
Yeah, I have played Bastion.
You know, like those challenge levels where you take like a weapon to, like you'd take the bow and you'd have to like hit all the targets in a certain number of shots?
Yeah.
Do you remember that? It sounds like what you're talking about is kind of like that. Just that... Oh man, I've got a nitronome, so what's the most like skillful thing I can do with a nitronome and make that a challenge?
Mm-hmm. Maybe having a charge time reduction would not be helpful in a certain case where this switch will go off in exactly 3 seconds, and you have to run to the next switch to open the door. And so, if you have a slower touch semi-deduction, you'll have enough time to go there, and you won't be able to make it to the door. Whereas, if you have a higher touch semi-deduction, you can make it through just in time to get past a certain door.
It's a fascinating idea.
But yeah, something other than hack and slash would make this. Like, it's not that I don't like hack and slash, I just like variety.
Yep.
In games where I can have so many options to choose from. A certain game type, like this one game, I can think of maybe 10 other gameplay modes rather than just Lockdown and Blast Network that can make this. You know, a certain experience for everyone to have, whether you're competitive or just casual.
Yeah. Like, I mean, even King of the Hill. Come on, man. You know, four on four Lockdown, or like Lockdown style King of the Hill would be like. It'd be crazy cool.
I remember when we did Lockdown, and we all just brought our catalyzers.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that alone made it fun for me to go on Lockdown. Yep. Rather than just be that kind of competitive mode. Some people just, you know what, I think when people play this game and they, I know people get stuck because of either the fire crystals nowadays, when we discussed about, oh, you have to have a level 7 5 star to be as powerful as a level 4 10 a level 10 4 star weapon,
right?
Sometimes people don't think about that, but when they reach level 5 and they figured out that they ran out of fire crystals, so they just stuck at 4 star, and really they don't know what to do unless grind.
Mm-hmm.
And so there's no definite reason as to why people stop,
mm-hmm.
but it's just that it's not giving the players more benefit. It doesn't give an equal layage between the pay to play and the free to play players, where they can't even spend money to get the stuff they need or want.
Just like stay and play the game for longer.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, shouldn't Sparrow Knights, like, invite a friend? It shouldn't be like, oh, here, have, like, what do they give you nowadays?
They give you the helmet, the gas mask helmet, the one that looks like a pyro helm.
Mm-hmm.
The bomb thing. Yeah, they give you that if you invite, like, I think, 10 friends or 5.
Should make it so that they give you the fire crystals that you specifically need. Wouldn't that incentivize people to share the game with their friends?
Yeah.
Or make many alts, I guess. Never mind.
Then again, just
generate resources. There would be so many alts on this game. Never mind. Sucky idea.
Well, that was the start of an idea.
Yeah, I guess.
What would give people an incentive to invite people? Like, League of Legends has a thing where, and if I forgot, you get a certain amount of RP, or was it IP?
It's IP to start, which is the in-game currency, like crowns, and then RP, which is like energy. If you keep inviting friends.
What if the I'm trying to, because alts are a thing. I'm trying to figure out a way how it cannot be broken to a certain extent. Maybe. Like, it has, like, wasn't there a thing where you had to pass a certain level?
Mm-hmm. To get the prize? Have to, in League of Legends, you have to get to level 10.
So what if Spawn Knight, you have to be a Vanguard?
That's pretty deep. Like, that would be someone has to, like, actually play for a long time. Maybe Knight Elite. I don't know. But yeah, something like that.
Yeah,
some mechanic like that.
Yeah, like, pass a certain mission or something. Like, so that not people will overuse the alts idea. How is the energy market now?
It's decent still. I'm surprised. It's still 8k.
Still?
Straight up 8k. Yeah, it hasn't changed.
Hmm.
I guess no one's playing, so no one's buying and selling, so there's no reason for it to change. I don't know. Surprised me, though.
8k.
Yeah, well, you know, maybe the in conclusion, I don't know. This has been like episode 101 of the Arsenal podcast, kind of almost.
Almost, except it's very late, very late night, and all we're talking about is how Sparrow Knights can do what and things and such.
Well, I think that's where we're at right now, right? Until they actually make another announcement or say, "Hey, here's the next thing that we're doing." It's kind of just a. Here's what we wish would happen. And here's what we think could help.
I miss the interaction between the devs and us.
Yeah. Too bad the community had to be so poopy that they had to stop doing that. It's a real shame, I tell ya.
Mm-hmm. The last time I saw a dev was in the Winterfest. They just hanged around the Heaven Garden.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone was just there for like 5 minutes and that was it. I don't know. Are you still recording?
Yeah, I am.
Oh, okay.
Just cobble together whatever I get.
Well.
Get back.
A quote,
Spiral Scientist.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
I think I made a slight misadjustment. I kind of did something, and I think I might have overdone it in Spiral Knights.
Oh?
Yeah.
How so?
I don't know if Glacy's told you. Of course, if Sky told you, but I've been doing secret things to Spiral Knights, and I don't know if this will go out, but I've been messing around, I should say,
yep.
with certain files.
Yep.
And I created new things.
Did you make banana?
What did you grow in the lab?
Pillow aura was a thing, so I put that in.
Oh, that's right. I remember seeing the banana aura.
Mm-hmm.
That was hilarious.
And so now I'm seeing people with banana auras on their body. And I did a few monster reskins, and that didn't work out so well. Mm-hmm. I wanted to make the crowns, like the actual crown texture, have it like rubies, like Zelda rubies, just for a joke, but because models cannot be, their model cannot be changed, but they can be retextured, the ruby just looks like a ruby inside like a diamond shaped crown.
It's a clever idea though.
If I can't have an update, I'll make my own.
You should make a sound pack.
I want to do that. I just don't know how to.
We should make a sound pack. Like
you, it's easily make a sound pack.
Yeah. We should stream making a sound pack. That would be fun.
You just get a sound and replace it with a file name.
Yeah, replace the OGG file.
What if we had Zelda's, what if we had Link, like, his many attack screams, hi,
yeah.
Like, as our slashes.
Yep.
And all you hear from every night is just, like, many voices coming.
Except for the caliber charge, which I happen to be spamming right now, in which case you hear, Demacia!
Demacia! We should totally do that.
That'd be fun.
Like, just for the heck of it, see what happens.
We should do that tomorrow.
Apparently not, I'm free.
I'm free tomorrow.
I don't have school for like 2 more weeks.
Oh wow, lucky you.
I looked at Maokai's shield bark thing, and I wanted to retexture a plate mail with that.
Oh, you're so clever.
And
no, seriously, all lumbers need to sound like Maokai.
Whoa.
The tree from League of Legends. For people that are watching this that only care about Spiral Knights, not League of Legends.
I don't know, we've just been playing a lot of League, so I got interested in both.
Yeah.
Why can't I mix things up? I played Super Smash. Why can't I have... I want a Mario cap in this game. I mean, they have the Power Glove from Nintendo. Why can't Sega put in another Nintendo reference so I can make fun of it?
When you pick up a movement speed buff... there's no sound effect for when a movement speed buff actually happens, is there?
I don't think so. I think it's the same for all buffs that pick up.
Yeah.
Wanted a Sanic. Gotta go fast sound, but never mind.
Gotta go fast when you pick up an attack one?
Gotta go fast!
I don't know, there's just some... Maybe when you dash.
You're too slow. That should be it. That's the buff sound. You're too slow, and when you dash, you gotta go fast.
Just replace every sound with brawl taunts.
What if we had the running, what if we had the walking sound instead of footsteps? It could be just like squeaky toys. So you just hear
That would be horrible. This squeaks for days.
Squeak, squeak, squeak. What if we voice acted for the bosses?
What if we voice acted the whole thing? Swish. Whap.
Slash, slash, whoop. Bomb down, explode.
Bloop.
Boom.
And then we just are like, bling, bling, bling.
Quack, and quack.
What if... Instead of that, we just voiced everything, no sound effect.
Yeah.
Like, actions, all the actions, but no sound effects.
Shoot, shoot, explode.
Just like charge. Actually gunshot, said gunshot. The set. Oh, yeah.
Charging, charging,
step,
charging.
Step, 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 step.
And stop.
We could make both of those. Like, one at a time, obviously. But we should totally do that, that'd be hilarious.
Dash! Chill back!
And of course, all of the sprites, when they attack, they say their own name in true Pokemon fashion.
Wait. What mobs actually make noises? I know Jellycube makes a noise, but what it just says jelly.
Squish.
Jiggly, 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 jiggly.
Like that's the walking animation. Oh my god, that would be horrible because there would be so many mini jellies everywhere, and there would just, you all you hear is like jiggly, 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 jiggly.
It's like you hear jiggly. It's like where's that coming from?
And what about this? What about the enemies that summon like more than once, like the scarabs? What would they say?
Oh man!
They would just go,
whoosh, click, 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 whoosh. And then, of course, just the one troll thing that we add is if a phantom spawns, it's a screamer, so it's like max sound, like screaming.
Wow!
Because we're cruel, we want to scare people when phantoms show up. Oh, and then man. We get banned for posting it on the forums, but it's funny.
I mean, as long as we don't post it on the forums, we'll be fine. We post it on YouTube, we no longer have a problem with it.
It would seem that way.
But I know for some, because I would post this on YouTube, but I know there will always be that one person that gets too excited, doesn't read the comments we post in, and be like, I'm gonna show this to everyone in the forums.
Yep.
And then we get banned because of that one person too excited to read things. It's like, oh, these guys actually made something new. You gotta check this out, GM. Look at this. Hey, that does look very interesting, but it applies to the TOI, so bam.
EOS. Ban hammer.
Ban
crowbar. Yeah, well, if you're open tomorrow, I'm down for making one of those sound packs. That'd be fun.
That would be super duper. Okay, I get up really early. Besides, I have, like...
I got classes until 2 in the afternoon, so... have to be after that, but... go let Glacies and Green play League of Legends.
Mm-hmm, and I'll just play, like, Super Smash for, like, another 2 hours.
We'll just do voices. Get Quote in on it, with his schmexy voice.
Right, Quote? Quote, it got muted, never mind.
Alright, well, I guess we'll wrap this one up, then.
Yep.
So, scatterbrained discussion on Gunner update, and one way the game might be improved. One of many. Everyone has their own ideas. I wonder if the devs still read the forums and see, like, these different ideas and go, that would be a good idea.
Either that, or you just take one glance at what people are arguing about. It's like, okay, we'll just move on.
Yes, that too. I'm actually surprised how bustling the forums are still, though.
Wait, they're still arguing?
Well, no, just people are still doing things on the forums.
Oh, yeah. RPs and events and people trying to come up with things to get people engaged. I think the most recent was that I've got into was the Secret Santa. And I love my gift.
What'd you get?
I got it basically in the Secret Santa forums. You just basically make art for others. And so from my request, my person made a really nice looking wallpaper that I still have.
Nice.
I love it.
Awesome.
Oh god, the mic mumbles, mic breaking.
Oh, so sorry.
That hurt.
Alright. Well, in the name of YouTube, thank you everyone for watching.
Thank you everybody and for listening. Jinx. And
Serjinx.
Ha ha ha.
And we will see you next time. Have a good one.
Have a good one.